So, your uncle. What's wrong with him?
He's possessed.
As in the devil?
Something like that. He says a dark man is following him, watching him at all times.
What do you make of it?
It's nonsense, of course. But I'd be lying if I said it didn't bother me. You see, it runs in my family.
Possession?
No, Detective. Deteriorating melancholy. Practically every member of the Hartwood family is driven mad before they grow old.
But Jeremy didn't kill himself. Is that why he's at your setup?
Despite being convinced that he is truly possessed, he decided to put his last chips on Dr. Gray and his psychoanalysis, figuring he might stumble upon some cure.
You mentioned a letter.
I received a disturbing letter from Jeremy accusing the staff and all the other patients of being involved in some cult. And now they are also out to get him.
Could it be real? Or is it all just in his head?
It's a story he tells himself, Mr. Carnby. Anything to avoid the truth.
Which is?
That we're all terribly insignificant. That people mean so very little to one another. That there is no one out to get Jeremy Hartwood because he isn't worth getting.
Here we are.
My uncle's not well, Mr. Carnby. I want to make sure he's all right.
Then what's my part in this? You couldn't get a cab?
I just wouldn't feel safe going alone. Did you bring a gun?
Yeah. You think it'll actually come to that?
No. But you might need to wave it around depending on how agreeable the staff will be.
What exactly are we gonna do when we find Jeremy?
I don't know. Let's just find him first. Hello? Hello?
Looks abandoned.
It can't be. There has to be someone around.
Wait here. I'll go around back. Now, what do we got here?
I'm not getting in there. Big tree to fit inside a conservatory. Nah, I'm not getting in there. What was that?
Every day your silence weighs a little heavier. It's been a difficult year for everyone, and many have lost all hope. I read in the papers about people suffering.
Don't mind if I do.
I need the key.
Please do not touch the boiler.
Huh. That doesn't look safe.
Hmm.
Sunday, June 20.
I need the key. It's wedged shut. Looks important.
The Great Depression. President Hoover raises
I need the key.
Thanks.
What are you doing? Who are you?
Whoa, pardon me. Excuse me. My name is Edward Garnby, private investigator. I hope you don't mind we let ourselves inside.
I do mind. This is private property. You can't just barge in here.
I'm sorry about all this, but I'm looking for my uncle. It's urgent, and no one was answering the door.
We can't hear you knocking anymore. None of us can.
Who is your uncle, darling?
Jeremy. Am I right? She has that Hartwood gloom, doesn't she?
That's right. I'm Emily Hartwood. I just came to make sure my uncle is all right.
Well, he is unavailable right now.
You will have to come back another day.
Unavailable? How? Is he sleeping? We can wait.
He's lost.
Don't I know you from somewhere?
Who's your man again, Miss Hotwood?
My name's Edward Carnby, private investigator.
Splendid.
Enough, all of you. Get back to your rooms. McCarthy, keep your eyes on the child. And you two, please leave immediately.
Look, we're not here to cause any trouble. Just let us see the old man, satisfy the curiosity of my client here, and we'll be off.
Jeremy has gone missing. There's no need to worry, but it might be some time before he turns up. The whole staff is looking for him.
What? He ran off?
I don't have time for any of this. Please, come back tomorrow.
All right, in that case, we'll just wait in his room. You don't mind, do you? It's upstairs, right?
Wait, you can't.
Don't worry, we'll be discreet.
In the corridor. It's the first door on your left. I'll tell Dr. Gray you're here.
Excellent. Thank you, madam. Here we are.
Let's look around. See if we can dig up any clues.
Anything important I should look out for? Did he keep a diary?
Not that I know of, but it wouldn't surprise me.
Every night the dark man stands opaque at the threshold of my room.
Hey, you know anything about this? Looks like some sort of talisman.
No, I don't. Oh, help me out here, will you?
Now, would it kill a guy to throw some of this stuff out? I'd be crazy too if I had this much junk lying around.
Striking. I want to save this one.
All right, come on. I want to go see Dr. Gray.
on, let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming. Miss Hartwood. Emily?
Christ, what the hell was that?
Can't go that way.
What the hell is going on?
Let them get inside, Compere. They're not the good guy.
Are you... Is this your store?
There are no owners here. We both strangers in Jeremy's store.
Jeremy did this? How?
The pact with the dog man. Jeremy warned us, but we didn't think much of it.
I'm Detective Edward Carnby. I was hired by Jeremy's niece to find him.
Oh, yeah? How much she paying you?
$150.
She's sure getting her money's worth tonight. Are you a thinking man, compare?
No, not if I can help it.
You know, I think Jeremy's hiding in a way we can't find him. He has this juju necklace that guides him.
The talisman?
That's right. It's some magic charm he got from Miss Jackson down the street.
The voodoo priestess?
You know surprising things, compare. Yeah, the Mama Loa. Here, take the key. I locked the gate to save her place from all the ghouls and goblins getting inside. Maybe if you go there, you can find some clues to show you the way.
Thanks. I'll have a look.
What?
Detective Khan.
recognize this place. It's Miss Jackson's seance parlor. It's the talisman, like the one in the painting. I think it's meant for the talisman. I think it needs numbers, like coordinates. Maybe there's something in Jeremy's notes. I think it needs numbers, like coordinates. Maybe there's something in Jeremy's notes. Showing something. A place? Where is that? Huh.
Detective, I was wondering when you were going to show up. Mrs. Thompson told me you were here. I understand you are working for Jeremy Hartwood's niece.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, you're not wrong. We came here for her uncle. I didn't expect this. You are Dr. Gray, right?
That's right. You don't happen to have some identification, Detective. I'm not keen on having strangers prying into my business. Oh, Detective Edward Carnby, Decatur Street, New Orleans. Enjoying the Vieux Carré, Detective? Those old French quarters, the voodoo people, the gangsters. I'm sure you live an exciting life.
Well, that's not quite like the stories, Doc. Just trying to make a living.
Aren't we all making a living? Well, welcome to DeSeto, Detective. I hope your time here will be useful. Now, what can I do for you?
Why don't you tell me where I can find Jeremy Hartwood?
Why wouldn't that make for a short visit? I wish I could tell you, but I'm afraid I don't know. A drink, Detective?
Anything brandy.
Oh, you do belong in the French quarters, Detective. Armagnac or cognac?
You know, just give me the cheap stuff. I'm not much of a connoisseur.
Having low standards is not a virtue, Detective. Let me see if I can broaden your perspective.
What can you tell me about Jeremy?
I wouldn't want to go into details about his condition. Doctor-patient confidentiality. I'm sure you understand.
Sure. But he is crazy. And he's gone missing. Why?
Here. Try this.
Ooh, it's good. Got a bite?
It's called a sidecar. The trick is not to be afraid of the tartness of the lemon. Then, for goodness sake, don't overdo the triple sec.
Okay, what can you tell me about Jeremy?
Well, let me think. He is an anxious man, constantly worried about events not presenting themselves according to his model of predestination. He complains about things not being carried out in the right order, and that some things simply shouldn't be. Is any of this helpful to you?
Not really. I was hoping for some direction, where to look next.
I'm sorry. I have nothing for you then. You should talk to my orderlies. They have been looking for him for a while now. I'm sure they would appreciate your help.
Yeah, I ran into Baptiste earlier. Come to think of it, he might have given me a lead.
Oh, excellent. So your investigation is already underway.
I'm gonna go, but I'm sure we'll meet again.
Looking forward to it. Safe returns.
Detective Carnby, how did you... Where did you go?
I was just talking to Dr. Gray.
You disappeared?
No, it's not what you think. Have you found anything strange going on here?
Yes. Everyone is being incredibly evasive and I can't figure out why.
No, I mean something you can't explain. Paranormal, even.
Detective? I really need you to get yourself together. I can't do this alone.
Forget it. I'll figure it out.
Do you want to come see Dr. Gray?
No. I want to try something. With this talisman, I think I can follow Jeremy to the place he mentioned in the book. What was the name? Do you remember something Spanish? Tarawea. Yeah, that's where I need to go.
Detective, are you going to be all right?
Yeah, of course. Go talk to Dr. Gray. We'll rendezvous later. This talisman brought me back from the French Quarter in the blink of an eye. If Jeremy can travel so easily, then he could be hiding anywhere, even Tarawea. If he can do it, so can I. I just need to figure out how the talisman works.
This must be the clock that Jeremy wrote about in the Commonplace book. Looks like the plate that held the talisman in the seance room. But it's broken and missing some pieces.
Sorry, Detective. Didn't mean to obstruct justice or anything.
That's fine.
You know, I'm kind of busy with my own case of a missing person. I was wondering if you've seen Grace, a girl about yay high?
I can't say that I have. Why are you asking?
Well, I'm looking for her.
Is she in trouble?
No. She's just hiding somewhere. We can't have a rascal like that running around unchecked at a time like this, you understand?
Well, I haven't seen her.
Well, let me know if you find her. I'll be around. I'll keep an eye out for your man, Jeremy. You scratch my back, Detective, and I'll scratch yours.
Looks like everything's back to normal here.
Emily's here.
saw your notice in the boiler room. You should...
There's no way I can get into this thing. Better leave it alone. There's no way I can get into this thing. Better leave it alone. Looks like all the patients are accounted for. Except for Jeremy.
Dr. Elmore Lee Gray is DeSeto's chief doctor.
Paul, you're right about the plates on the board.
I need the key. I'm not gonna walk out of this now. I need to help Emily save her own. Eccentric.
I did it. I crossed the thresholds to my intended destination without...
What are these symbols? Looks like alchemy or star constellations.
Will I need to remember how to get them out again? They are locked up for good reason. I am sure she is still able to whisper the answer in the ears of the wrong people. But not for long. I will see her burned soon enough. That black goat will be sacrificed to put an end to it all. Then it will all be over. No more Derceto, and sadly, no Astarte. Those good pirates of Pontchartrain.
Will I need to remember how to get...
Paintings got some grim-looking rot on them.
God!
need the key.
Detective Conby had a hard time understanding what had happened. It did feel similar to when he was pulled into the French Quarter.
Lost Plantations of Louisiana.
It's wedged shut.
Thank you.
Huh. Got it. Nice. I need the key.
Kitchen. I assure you.
Oh, no, I'm sorry.
I promise you. Mr. Hartwood is nowhere near my kitchen, and neither should you be. Don't make me kick you out of this house.
Sorry.
Now get out!
Yeah.